Welcome everyone into the Bass Format 1 patch 1.06. We got 1v1 on Forza Horizon 2 today. And in the top left, playing as Isengard, it's going to be Isengard player Soprano. And he's going with one Furnace, one Rogue Barak. And in the bottom right, it's going to be Rohan player Mergen. And he's going with two Farms and Mary. Alongside with peasants with draft, one peasant unit will across the river while another is going for the settlement to create a lonely farm, two farms in the base. On the other side, we can see that Uruk-hai hordes are moving towards the Rohan base from the south side of the map. And from the middle, we can see that peasants are moving towards the Uruk-hai barrack. Uruk-hai is popping out more and more. We got lumber mill created from the settlement, and the other settlement will be taken and be creating here a lumber mill, I guess, as well. We can see that peasants are going into the Uruk-hai. Uruk-hai should be in the block formation to receive 25% of armor, which they did, and that's why those peasants, even with draft, had got no chance. We can see that another settlement has been taken, and the farm is going to go over here for Rohan. The wolf mentioned that Rohan could eventually go for this middle side workler, but because I think he realized that his opponent is Isengard, and most likely he's going to rush him, he decided not doing it, and just avoid the rush from himself, so he was rushing Isengard. Isengard is using War Chant, he's going for the peasants. Peasants are trying to go for the works. Good micro by Isengard over here, not being catched by works, not that great by Mergen, who lost one peasant with draft. And now Uruk-hai are moving back into those peasants, and they will definitely kill them. There is another battalion of Uruk-hai, actually two, quaking by Isengard player, and he is not going for any more furnaces. And there is another furnace actually. And yeah, peasants will be killed one more time. But at least War Chant has been used already, so there will not be creeps done. As we can see, there is Mary on the south side of the map, clocking out. There we go, with some Uruk-hai hordes camping over here near him. And one of those units getting away, so this is why this mirror has been clocked out, throwing rock into the Uruk-hai's. But it's not enough, those Uruk-hai's getting away. Another Uruk-hai battalion is moving forward towards the side of the map, another furnace as well. As we can see, there we go with Rohirrim. So Rohan got stables already, he's popped out some Rohirrim's warriors. And he will try to get resources, and it seems that no, it's going to be Isengard who took all the resources. But of course, it's going to be Rohan who will be forced to fight with Orcs. It's going to be okay, of course, he will be able to do it. Rohirrim will survive, but one of them will be killed, and one of them are severely damaged. Let's check the Mary. Mary is definitely in bad shape. He got Elephant Clock. But I don't think so that Mergen will be able to use it one more time. Yes, and Mary has been killed. Farm from Rohan over here, but on the other side of the map, Rohan is almost going to lose his farm. But of course, Rohirrim warriors, Rohirrim knights are already over here. Level 2 for Rohirrims as well. And as we can see that Soprano is losing his Uruk-hai. He definitely needs some pikemen. He got one on the battlefield, another in production just up here. He's quaking units. He got five furnaces at the moment. Let's check the resources for those players. As we can see, not that much, only 200 for Soprano at the moment, while Mergen got 400 at the moment. Just use the resources. He's going for the worker, getting some treasures as well as experience. Definitely killing those two orcs as well as on the northern side of the map. But as we can see, the northern side will be taken by Uruk pikemen. There was a war chant to definitely scare those Rohirrims. Those Rohirrims are not in great shape. Then they've been attacking the orcs and kill them. On the other hand, it's still Mergen who got his farm on the opposite side of the map, and he's popped out some peasants. Definitely good against pikemen. So it's worth mentioning that Royal Peasants are really good against pikemen with draft, and you should definitely make them. But of course, Berserkers are a different story. So those peasants are going to be killed. 2 power points at the moment for Rohan, while his Isengard counterpart guard 2 power points already in use. Of course, it's going to be industry. And we got Work Pit on the way with Work Riders. Nothing has been created by this Uruk pit, actually, but on the south, Isengard was able to creep out and free the outpost. We got 2 Rohirrim's battalions. They will not be a threat to pikemen, so the settlement and the Rohan farm will go down. In the meantime, Merjun is going definitely for the settlement for the elven, for the mills, and maybe we'll take the outpost to create. No, it's not going to happen. At the north, actually, they're doing a pretty good job. The blacksmith, the settlement is free, but it seems that it's going to be one more time lumber mill. Of course, we got works on the battlefield, so those peasants are nothing at the moment. We got the outpost taken on the northern side of the map, but it's going to be hard. Warchon is in place, and Hull is used as well. Rohirrim's has been killed a little bit, and heroic statue is going down. Archers going into the outpost, but Rohirrim's bad micro over here by merging with Rohirrim's. He lost this entire battalion, and it's going to be Isengard who received 1 power point. We got a vision of Palantir as well, 2 power points at the moment by destroying all those stuff, and this outpost will most likely going down. Almost 3 power points for Merjun. I don't know what he's going to do with it. Maybe he's going to wait for Elfen summon and just kill some of those pikemen. But I don't think so. It's going to be enough. As we can see, Rohan outpost is going down. Rohan archery as well. But in the meantime, Merjun is going for some settlements, create some farms, trying to get up on the echo side. And here we go. Here we go, summon. And of course, Merchant will try to protect this outpost. It was a little bit too late, but at least Work Riders will not be able to kill those Rohan archers. And alongside with elves, it should be enough to reclaim this outpost on the northern side of the map and as well on the south side of the map. So Merchant got almost entire control over himself. As we can see on the middle, lumber mill will be created, and the middle site from Isengard is taken. Now we got armory from Isengard. He doesn't have yet power those upgrades bought it. He's going with Banacaris. He used industry one more time. We got still work riders in production. We got archers being killed, those summon archers, but nonetheless Elf is able to spread out his units and reclaim the settlement, create farmers over here. And we got Archer Angel level 2, so there could be even fire arrows from Merjun. While Soprano got to back up and deal with those Elfin warriors at first. It's not that easy. They are harder to tramp when they get stronger their weapons. Nonetheless, it looks like that it's going to be Rohan who reclaim entire map. We can see both the outposts in his control. We can see most of the settlements in his control as well. Let's check his base. He got the armory for himself. He's going with Banacaris. He's not rushing towards forge blades or heavy armors. And overall, he's doing pretty good job. How about resources? Almost 1,000 for Soprano, while his opponent got 1,700, so it's quite a bit. How about power points? Almost 4 power points for Soprano. Soprano would like to wait for Frozen Rain in this situation, and his opponent got 1 power point for heal, for example, or stuff like that. Work Riders already received Forge Blades and Heavy Armor. So it seems, and even this armory has been destroyed, so I think Fire Arrow has been bought by Isengard as well. This will allow him to reclaim some of the settlements and maybe even destroy the outposts. But it seems that he doesn't want to do it. He got 3 battalions of Warriders on at least level 2, and with all the upgrades that are necessary. So definitely settlements will be reclaimed and lumber mills will appear. I don't think so that's going to be a good idea. Hawk and Warchant has been used, but I think the heroic statue got to be destroyed. Those combos battalions as well, as fast as possible, and will has been cancelled by Mergen. But Soprano is going to continue. Definitely he got enough units to do it. He got level up work riders with Hog ability and all those upgrades, those arrows from archers doing almost no damage towards them, and archer range level 2 is going down. But on the server side of the map, Mergen got Theoden with his leadership and Mary one more time to annoy his opponent. But as we can see, there are pikemen that will receive banner carries and they are got already heavy armor. So it's enough to kill this little hobbit. It seems that Isengard one more time going to reclaim everything, destroying the outpost on the northern side of the map, getting level up, and I think even power points are in his favor. Yeah, almost 6 power points for Soprano. He got the industry available. He could use it on some of those furnaces. As we can see, he's doing it right now, right away. And Theoden with 2 battalions of combos with Rohirrim's heavily damaged. It's not looking good at the moment, but at least Forge Blades has been received, and armory for Rohan is going down. So there got to be heavy armor purchase as well by Rohan. And now only thing that Rohan could do is to moving forward, but there is lures already on the battlefield. And it seems that armory for Isengard is going to be bought again. So no fire arrows, I supposed, has been brought to life. And right away, mill level 3, some arrow on it. Worth to mention, those combos doesn't have fire arrows. And there is lures, there are some. There is one battalion of Uruk pikemans that are getting away. Where are work riders? That is a question. They're moving through the middle. 3 battalions of work riders, pretty well upgraded. Definitely these lures should go over here. Pin as fast as possible Theoden. We got available a vision of Palantir from Isengard. He could definitely use it to catch those Rohirrims. We got pikemans, 3 battalions of archers, and even elfin warriors on the battlefield. Upgrades for fire arrows. So it looks like that Rohan has got all his upgrades. At the right time, the stables will be recreated for Horde Shields upgrade for Rohirrims. Nonetheless, it's not looking that great for our Isengard player, for our Rohan player. Isengard need just 1 power point for Frozen Rain that will allow him to destroy this outpost with all those units that he got. He's going to create combos. He receive fire arrows, so he got all the necessary tools to just do it. And what is weird, let's check the resources that Isengard get. He got to 1k at the moment, and he could at least could try this out, try to take this outpost on the northern side of the map. As we can see, 3 battalions of work riders. We got Uruk eyes as well as combos on the way. We got lures with his pin ability. So it's not looking that great for Rohan. It could be even the last attack over here by Isengard. It could end even the game. Rohan been dragged out of the outpost. There are elephant summon available. But as we can see, battalion of combos over here will be killed. We got combos from Isengard. Isengard should use Warchant. Warchant has been used already, as well as Frozen Rain. And it's going to be painful. Warg Rider is going forward. Lures is going forward to just pin the Theoden that just stopped. And he will receive pin at the moment. All those Elfin Warriors will be killed. There is nothing that Rohan could do. There is of course heal available from Merjun, but I don't think so he will use it. He just used it, but nonetheless he will lose this Theoden. So heal was the waste. And it will be Lures who is going to kill Theoden to a little bit to get more experience. Elfin warriors will be killed over here. Lures on level 2. very sorry. And almost all units from Rohan has been killed. Rohan tried to reclaim a little bit of settlements to back up his economy. But it's going to be really hard. He loses the outpost, he loses tons of units, 3 power points after this battle for Isengard. And Rohan got only Rohirrim, so pikemen will definitely be used. And those war riders who are leveling up will definitely be put in use as well. We got Frozen Rain for 3 minutes that will affect Isengard, giving him, I think, 50% of damage and armor. And as we can see, Isengard is going to prepare himself to just attack his opponent. He's going to purchase this outpost on the southern side of the map, even maybe on the northern side of the map. After this, he will destroy this farm as well as this one with Warg Riders, as we can see. So it's going to looking really bad for Rohan. Hawk ability has been used. Palantir is available as well as Warchant, so there is nothing that Rohan could do. And there we go. Palantir has been used. And Rohan got to get away over here, as we can see. 4 power points at the moment for Isengard. 2 power points only for Merchant for Rohan player. And yeah, Rohan got to get away to his castle. He doesn't have will to heal his units. While Isengard is closing in his base, at least try to. He got siege works from the southern side of the map. And he reclaimed entire base for himself. We got, of course, postern gate upgrade for Rohan, so he can evacuate not on the not near his gates, but nonetheless, we got war riders who will definitely catch all those Rohirrims. We got really good in position those pikemen to protect the lumber mills. I think all of them almost except this one. And it looks like that Rohan is going away, going out, trying to deal some damage, trying to get some more power points. Of course, he got more mobile units over here because he's facing Kobos and Lures. But nonetheless, he cannot create farms over here because they will be already destroyed. And now we can see that Warg Riders are going in. Hawk ability should be used as well as Warchant. Warchant has been used, Hawk ability as well. And Rohan got to get away. So Merjun is known that he cannot fight head-on with Warg Riders in this situation. Frozen Rain will be available one more time from Isengard. It's just a matter of seconds, and he got control over entire game over here. We got Ram instead of Ballestas from Isengard. Oh, pikemen get some kills over here. We got combos, we got Warg Riders. Oh, there is Palantir available. I don't think so that should be used at the moment. Oh, we got Elven Summon. We got Frozen Rain used. So bonuses from Isengard. Theoden and Knights and Rohirrim is getting to the pikemen. They hasn't been in preoccupied formation, so they don't deal that much damage. Palantir has been used to just kill some units that trying to going away, and Saruman appears 6 power points for Isengard, while his opponent got only 3. Saruman on the battlefield as well. It's even worse. The speechcraft for those units, as well as leadership and Wormtongue to capture some Rohirrims, if it's going to be possible. And almost level 3 on Lures. It's not looking good for Merjun. Soprano definitely is going now for Ballistas, and he will deal with this wall of Rohan. Rohan is trying to protect himself. He's going for the will. He's going for a heroic statue to boost himself, but it seems that Mergen, after saw the Saruman, he decided to leave the game. He knew what's coming, that the Rams and Ballistas will definitely destroy him. Anyway, really good game by both the players, actually. Just Mergen wasn't able to execute it in the right time. And he lost quite a bit of those settlements, those Rohan farms, for the behalf of his opponent. Anyway, really good game. Thank you for watching. Feel free to subscribe and follow me on Twitch and YouTube. And may the force be with you. Bye-bye.